Now, this is extremely important thing to understand. The charge spread over the spherical shell behaves as if it was at the center, and from there it is producing what the whole thing is concentrated as a point charge at the center, and it is from there that it is producing all the field. So there is no difference between them, right? There is no difference between them. The field due to a charge Q spread over the surface area of a spherical shell is the same as it would have been due to the whole charge concentrated at the center of the spherical shell and this charge creating a field E at point P. But you have to remember, this is only for however this holds only for R greater than R, as we'll soon see. Okay, we'll soon see that this holds only for R greater than R. If I am within the shell, then we'll see what happens. But if you are outside the shell, okay, if you are outside the shell, then you can think that the whole charge is actually at the center, and it is due to that which due to that charge that the field is being created. This becomes very important when we go ahead to understand the concept of potential. Okay, so hold this in mind. Hold this in mind, right?
What if we write E as sigma upon E naught?
Sigma upon E naught?
Yeah, because the surface is the charge, and charge is sigma Q upon area, and the area is the
charge is spread over here. The field we are finding out here. The charge is not here.
No, but the charge is not.
The charge is here.
So why not write sigma upon capital R square 1 by E naught R square?
No. Look, this thing, you're talking about this, no?
Mm-hmm.
And you say that Q by 4 pi capital R square should be written as sigma.
Mm-hmm.
What advantage do you get out of that?
Just saying it can be written like that too.
You can, if you want. But it will become more complicated, because then you'll have to multiply it by R square, capital R square here and here. So Q by 4 pi epsilon 4 pi R square becomes sigma. So it becomes sigma upon epsilon naught into capital R square upon small R square.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Reducing terms and we don't need
it. Fine. So this is easier. Why? Because we just kind of think in our mind that all this charge is collapsed at the center, and from there it is producing the field. So it becomes kind of the familiar result for the point charge, right?